Up to this point, we have focused our attention on the transfer of heat, Q. It is one of the two ways energy can be transferred between two objects. The other form of energy transfer is work, W. If the system does work, the energy change is negative. If work is done on the system, the energy change is positive. The system's energy really does not care if it gains or loses energy in the form of work or heat. It's all the same. Energy can be gained in the form of heat and later lost in the form of work. Putting this all together, we come up with the mathematical expression for the first law of thermodynamics. The internal energy of a system, delta U, is equal to Q plus W. Energy is a state function. What this means is that it only matters where you start and where you finish. We already saw this concept in action when we used Hess's law. All we really cared about is having the right starting reactants, and once all the chemical reactions were added up, we had the right final products. Are heat and work state functions? Does it only matter where we start and where we finish? It turns out that the path we take to get from start to finish will have a profound effect on the values of Q and W. But despite the fact that neither Q nor W is a state function, their sum, the internal energy change, is. What this means is that if one path increases the value of Q by an amount X, then the value of W must correspondingly decrease by this amount. In our course, the only work we will consider is the work done by a system as it expands and pushes against a constant pressure, or as it contracts. For example, for a reaction that produces a gas, the work required by that gas to push back the atmosphere and enter the gaseous phase is work, and it must be accounted for within the calculation of the energy change within the system. As we saw earlier, the enthalpy change is equal to the heat of the reaction if that reaction occurs under a constant pressure. But what if the reaction occurs under a constant volume? In that case, there is neither a contraction nor an expansion, and if so, no work is done. Therefore, the internal energy change given by heat plus work simply becomes the heat. So for any reaction at constant volume, the heat of reaction is the change in the internal energy. The heat of reaction is always the heat absorbed or released by the reactants as they turn into products, but whether or not it equals to the enthalpy change or the change in internal energy depends on what was kept constant, pressure or volume. If both remain more or less the same, which is often the case for reactions involving only liquids and solids, then the enthalpy change and the change in internal energy are equal to the heat of reaction, and thus equal to themselves. Finally, a mole of water weighs roughly 18 grams and occupies roughly 18 milliliters. Same applies to a mole of ice. But returning to our formula, PV equals NRT, a mole of water vapor occupies roughly 25 liters at room temperature. In short, gases dominate the volume. Therefore, the formula relating the enthalpy change to the change in internal energy only concerns itself with the amount of gas consumed or produced during a reaction.